I'm at the junkyard. This is a Volvo S60 2007. We are in Canada. CEM model. It's missing the windshield cowl underneath. Also the wiper mechanism. I'm not sure if you need to remove it to get access, but you need to remove the wiper arms, and usually they are stuck. So don't force on there. Use a puller. Go to a garage. Ask a guy to get a puller. Don't shake them too much, especially in you know, if you are in the belt, salt belt area. So this is obviously the well-known problem. You can see the corrosion right there on those pins. That will throw a lot of codes. You may lose power, it may not start, you may have the transmission banging, shifting hard. Oh, a lot of problems. You can repair this thing either XE Modex in Canada, which are pretty expensive. Perhaps you can also find a local store, like a TV shop store, if they are doing. It's really annoying to remove this thing from the car. This has a lot of connectors like this, and basically you need to switch them with a screwdriver all the way, but sometimes they are stuck and it's really difficult to access a few of them. They are in the front here. It's very, very tight access from underneath inside the car. There's also a connector in front, so it's a core. But what I want to show is that it appears there was a new cover, a redesigned cover. I don't know if it's this one or not. Let me just give you the numbers, so maybe someone can give us, you know, someone knows if this was the redesigned cover or not. But the design is really tricky, because, and this is mostly from 2004 to 2009 for S60 and 2007 for V70, the problem. Usually the 2001, 2003 with the, they had a different CEM and a different cover here, and it didn't have that problem. I think it had a different cover, I'm not sure it's 100%. But there's several problems here. You see this, they use a small strap like this, but if I pull in there, it's really not hard to just make a passage for water, because this is really sitting and you'll have plenty of water, especially when it rains. You have these drains and they go underneath. It's right here, that small, this thing. But these drains, usually they don't really get clogged unless you have a lot of leaves, but they do have small holes here on the side, so these holes do get clogged. There's another one on the other side. So there's water rising here, and the cover, it has a seal. It's like a rubber seal, which obviously may not last 15 years or 20 years, and will start leak, especially I think if it wasn't tightened properly. There's four screws, and you notice they put a different, a specific screw which has a metal washer and a rubber washer underneath, but this has to be really sealing here, this holes, otherwise it's gonna leak in there. So it's a design that, say these are the washer, the metal one and the rubber one. It's a design that's perhaps not perfect. And when it's going to pass, let the water pass the seal, what's happening, I believe, is just a guess, correct me. You see, you have this kind of sponge here, strange. And I did notice, you know, here you see the dirt right there. You could see the dirt went where the water went in there, and there the water may just leak past the CEM. However, this sponge will get wet with water and will start dripping. And if you notice, it has like it's a small area where it is kind of was perhaps leaking a lot, and it leaks right on top of this connector. And obviously this, not even the you have that corrosion, that's like green stuff, but it's going to leak furthermore into this CEM, so it's going to corrode it, and you need to get it repaired, because replaced, you probably won't be willing to spend $2,000 of how much Volvo is asking for this. However, I think I'm pretty correct on this, but you can put a CEM from another car a used one that's in good condition. And I will link, if I don't link, just ask me in the comment section, but I have a blog where I have a link for a company that can, if you have the dice, you need to plug it into the OBD port and you have a computer, you don't need to have the VIDA software, just the dice unit. You can connect yourself through the internet to a company that would upload the software and program your replacement CEM. So that's the cheaper option. So yeah, you may want to maybe remove everything and check on your car, because I can see this is really exposed to water leak. 2004 to this being a 2007 with the problem, I would guess it's all the way to the end of the production line. This is just for comparing. A 2003 is going to be the older CEM model, so different than the 2004 and up. Notice the small enclosure here is also very, very different looking. I did not hear about people having problem with water ingress in this older CEM, 2001-2003. Maybe it's not impossible it will leak, because it looks to be about the same idea of sealing. It's just sealing around here, and there's a cover with another seal. And it's interesting because this rubber, this cable, it's really passing through an almost open hole really close to the bottom. But there is a big rubber with like three parts on it, so perhaps this thing is sealing properly, perhaps. I don't see on this car any water leaks or traces of so. And there is no corrosion, but I think one of the things that may have helped is that the design of the CEM makes it not standing underneath the opening, so it's more towards the front of the car, so it's not sitting right here underneath. So if the water comes to leak over this opening, it's not going to leak over the CEM, and perhaps not even over this connector, is going to leak around it. There's just cable underneath, you see, there's no components, electrical components. So this perhaps was a safer design, and then Volvo updated, put a new type, a new model of CEM with completely different design here. And I did have to remove the wiper mechanism. Is really not complicated, at least on this 2003. So the way it goes, you have, and by the way, watch your hands, really use gloves, because this is very sharp metal edge. So there's one 10 millimeter here, there's another 10 millimeter, and there's kind of a bushing that gets into that hole. So you need to toss it towards the side to free the bushing. And otherwise it came out, I just cut that coal. It's right there. I did cut it because I'm in the junkyard. But I didn't undo these arms. But there was a small bump here. It didn't come out because it was stuck in the plastic. I just had to force it a little bit, but it's just really just a plastic cover, not much worries about it. And there's a connector with a just depress that small metal tab. Okay.